Hi children, welcome to today's online class. And we have already seen the current electricity introduction part is over, and we have seen what is a conductor, what are the current carriers, okay, and what is a current, defined current, okay, and what is EMF. Everything we have seen, okay. See now. Okay, what is the current then? Current is nothing but it is a rate of flow of charge, okay, through any cross section of a conductor in a particular direction. Okay, therefore the current I, that is equal to current I, that is nothing but Q divided by T. Therefore Q, amount of charge, it flows in a time T through a conductor. Therefore the current can be written as, that is Q by T, or in a differential form it is dQ by dt. Everything you have seen right now. See, now we are going to see a new topic, what is called drift velocity. Drift velocity of what? Of electrons in a conductor. Okay, therefore now, as you all know, the conductors, they have so many number of free electrons. Okay, free electrons are nothing but the valence electrons. Okay, so, and these free electrons are only responsible for conduction. Why? Because all the other electrons are very much bound to the nucleus. They cannot move. Only the valence electrons, which are free, they can move. They are very much free. So what they'll do, they actually freely move from one atom. They can jump from one atom to another atom, and throughout the volume of the conductor they can move freely. That is why they are free electrons. But they can move only within the conductor. They cannot move out of the conductor. Within the conductor they are very much free to move. Okay, and you know that at room temperature, therefore how, what is the in a conductor, if you take a conductor, what is the number density of free electron? See, that number density of free electrons in a conductor, that is around very large, 10 power 29 per meter cube per unit volume. That is given by N, number density of electrons, that is given by N, small n, and it is 10 power 29 per meter cube, right? And all these electrons, okay, so many number of electrons are there, and these electrons at room temperature, what they do, they'll be moving randomly in every possible direction, okay, and it is very much similar to that molecules, motion of molecules in a what is it, gas, molecules of gas, how they are moving, freely. Like that, these electrons also move, okay, randomly in every possible direction. Okay, therefore what is the, because they move, what is the speed then? Therefore what is the average speed? Therefore the average speed, that speed is nothing but which speed? It is thermal speed. Why thermal speed? Because they are getting energy only because of at, what is that, because of temperature, external temperature, external at room temperature. The room temperature, they are having some energy. The electrons are getting some energy. That energy is nothing but thermal energy. Because of the thermal energy, the electrons, they are actually freely moving within the conductor. Because you know very well, if the electron has to move, means there should be some, what is that, energy is required now. So that energy, they are getting thermal energy from outside. Okay, at room temperature, the electron acquires some thermal energy. Because of that, they are very much free to move within the conductor. Therefore, now the question is, what is the average thermal speed of free electrons? Free electrons, okay, you can say at room temperature, is given by, you see, you cannot even imagine, that is 10 power 5 meter per second. Okay, 10 power 5 meter per second, enormous amount of speed. They are moving with a speed, that is average thermal speed of free electrons at room temperature is 10 power 5 meter per second. Right, this is speed, that is why I am telling it is thermal speed. Okay, but the direction of motion of free electrons is, what is that, random. Randomly they are moving, they are not moving in a particular direction. Therefore, if I say that, okay, if you want, for example, if, okay, U1, U2, U3, etc. up to UN. This is the thermal velocities. Thermal, it is not speed, thermal velocity. I am taking direction also into consideration now. Okay, thermal velocities of N free electrons. N free electrons in a conductor. Okay, so now each and every electron is having some, what is that? The thermal speed is 10 power 5 meter per second, right? But they are moving in a different direction. Okay, now let U1, U2, U3, etc. up to UN are thermal velocities of, what is that? N number of free electrons in a conductor. Therefore, what is the average thermal velocity? Average thermal velocity of all the electrons. Okay, that will be equal to, what is average velocity? U1 plus U2 plus etc. UN divided by N. Correct? Okay, therefore, the average thermal velocity of all the electrons, that is equal to this, but you know that the directions are random. Okay, therefore, that should be equal to the for 0, 1. Are you following? Why? Why speed is not 0? Thermal speed is not 0. Average thermal speed is equal to 10 power 5 meter per second. But thermal velocity of electrons will be equal to 0. Why? Because they are moving randomly in different direction. Therefore, there is no, which says that there is no net flow of charge in a particular direction. There is no net flow of charge in a particular direction. Okay. If there is no net flow of charge in a particular direction, you know that there will not be any current, no current in a conductor. Okay. Therefore, as such, if you take a conductor, okay, and the conductor has so many free electrons, and all the free electrons are also moving. They are not at rest. The free electrons are moving, but in spite of that, we are not getting any current. Why? Because there is no net motion in a particular direction. There is no net motion in a particular direction, because you know that the electrons, they move in a particular direction only, that will give you current. But here they are moving in different direction. There is no net motion of charge in a particular direction. Therefore, the current will be equal to zero. Are you following? So this is about the average thermal velocity. Okay, now what I'm doing, when I'm applying some potential difference, okay, it is a conductor. Now you see, it is a conductor. Okay, let me take a conductor A X, Y. It's too bad. Now, therefore, it is a conductor, and let me name it as X, Y. Okay. And what I am doing, I am applying a potential difference. Okay. Therefore, when I apply a potential difference, a battery I am connecting. If I connect a battery, now what happens? See. Before that, okay, before connecting a battery, let me have one key, a key here. Okay, now to start with, I am not connecting, it is an open circuit, correct? When it is an open circuit, what is the potential difference between X and Y? The X and Y, no potential difference. Why? Because it is a open circuit. Okay. Therefore, now the electrons inside, what they do? The electrons will be, all the electrons will be, now it will be moving in different directions. Okay. This is the motion of the electron in a, like this, when there is no is that potential difference. Okay, therefore, because of this randomness, what, there is no current in the circuit. There is no current in the circuit. As such, why? Though the electrons are very much free to move, but they are not moving. There is no net motion in a particular direction. Okay, now that is why we have seen that the average thermal velocity of all the electrons that is equal to zero. Okay, therefore, there is no current also. Okay, now what I am going to do is I am going to apply a potential difference. Once I apply some potential difference here, V, let it be. Okay, what is the potential? X is at higher potential and Y is at lower potential. And the potential difference between X and Y will be V. Okay. Now what happens? The electrons, okay, the electrons now, okay, this is very, very important. Now, therefore, the electrons are, see, here, before applying the potential difference, the electrons were moving randomly, okay. Now, once I apply a potential difference, okay, now the electrons are actually getting in addition to the thermal velocity, okay, there is one more thing is happening here. Why? Because the electrons now, all the electrons will be, okay, drifted towards the electrons are negative charged. They will be, electrons will be now moving in this direction, drifted towards the higher potential. Towards a higher potential. Are you following? Therefore, why? Because the electrons will experience a force. Okay. What is the force? V is the, what is V? V is a potential difference. Once there is a potential difference, there will be some electric field. Okay. In a conductor. What is the direction of the electric field? What is the direction of the electric field? Electric field will be from positive to negative. Therefore, the electric field will be in this direction. Okay, but the electrons now, what it will move, it will try to move in the, what is that, in which direction? It will be drifted towards the positive electrode, positive side of the conductor, which is the positive side, X. Okay, but they cannot, just like that, you cannot say that electrons, once you are applying a potential difference, that just like that, it will go like this. No chance. The electrons cannot move. They cannot jump from one end to another end just like that. They cannot move. Why? Why? Because they have some thermal energy also, no? Okay, so because of the thermal energy, what happens? The electrons experience a force that is, first I'll tell you, that is equal to EE. E is minus. Okay? Minus E. Why? F is equal to QE. Na? Here, electron. Electron means minus. Charge of electron is minus. Therefore, what is F is equal to E into E. Therefore, they experience a force, okay, which is opposite to the direction of the electric field. Therefore, they will be experience a force in this direction. Okay. Therefore, because there is a force, they will get some acceleration. Okay, so the electrons, now what happens, now very important, the electrons will be now accelerated. Electrons will be accelerated. How they will be accelerated? Now you see, here as they, as electron, it will be moving. I'm taking only single electron now, okay. What it will do? So, it will be accelerated. No, and accelerated towards the positive side of the conductor, no doubt. But, they have thermal velocity, okay, and because of that thermal velocity, what happens? See, there is some acceleration, but in addition, acceleration due to the applied electric field, okay, but in addition to what is called thermal velocity, okay. Therefore, because of that, what they'll do, they take a curved path. Curved path, see, they move like this, okay. Okay, why? Why? Because what is the thermal speed is very, thermal, what is the thermal velocity? 10 power 5 meter per second. Okay, so they can, that influence will be always there. Okay, they cannot, just like that, they cannot move like this. Just now I told you, they cannot move in a straight line from Y to X. Okay, why? There is an influence of, what is that? Thermal speed. Therefore, what they'll do, they'll move in a, what is that, curved path. Okay, curved path means as they move, But what they are moving like this, as they move, okay, they will be getting accelerated. They are accelerated. They are getting some extra energy because of that. They move. As they move, immediately what they do, they suffer some collision. Why? They suffer collision with what? Ions or atoms on their path. On their path, then they're definitely what will be there? There'll be so many ions or atoms, okay? So what they'll do, as they're accelerated because of the external electric field, okay, they want to move to, what is that, towards X only, but they cannot move, they cannot fly off like that. As they immediately, they suffer some collision. Okay, as they suffer some collision, whatever energy they acquired because of the applied electric field, everything they lose. They lose all the energy because of the collision. Okay, then after that, once again, after what, they are losing all the energy, once again they will get accelerated because there, what is that, electric field is there, no? Okay, permanently there is some here, there is an electric field. Therefore, what happens? What is that? Because once again they get, what is that, energy, they accelerated and they come here. Okay. Okay. And after that, once again they lose energy. They undergo collision. Okay. After that, what they do? Okay. Because here, it is not that always they will go towards X only. There may be some chance for, because thermal speed may sometimes dominate. Okay, therefore what they'll do, randomness may dominate. Okay, randomness, thermal speed is dominating, is randomness. Therefore what they'll do, even they move like that also sometime. Okay, okay, once again here it is undergoing some collision. This is okay, atom with that, it is going like this, like this, like this. Okay, then after that, it is coming like this. Okay, collision. Then every collision, it is losing whatever energy it acquired because of, what is the electric field, everything is, what is that, lost due to collision with the atoms or ions on its path. Okay, therefore like that, it goes like that, is random. Okay, it is going. Okay, and then after that is coming. Okay, like that, I'm just randomly it is going like that. Okay, and finally, with the, therefore so many, it is taking some curved path. Finally, what is that, till this is what is that, this is going, and every time it is accelerated, it acquires some energy and it wants to go towards X, but it undergoes, by after traveling certain distance, what it does, it undergoes some collision. Once, because of the collision, all the acquired energy because of the external field, everything will be lost. Okay, once again, what is that? It is acquiring, it is accelerated and it goes to certain distance. Once again, it suffers collision like that. It suffers so many collisions as they, what is that? As the electron travels from Y to X. Okay, then is it clear? I think you are able to understand. Okay, therefore, what is that? This is, here the electron is getting here, now coming. Therefore, what is drift velocity? Electron is here. The electron here is drifted from Y to X because of the external electric field. Correct? Therefore, it has some energy, or it has some thermal velocity. And in addition to the thermal velocity, what is that? It has a very small velocity, what is it, is added because of the external electric field. Okay, but average thermal velocity is equal to zero. But here, in the presence of the electric field, its velocity, average velocity is not equal to zero. Non-zero, right? It is having some non-zero velocity. Okay. And that velocity is what is called drift velocity. Okay. And it is with that velocity, what is that? The electrons are drifted from the negative end of the conductor to the positive end of the conductor. Are you following? Therefore, the drift velocity? The average velocity of all the free electrons, okay? Okay, is now not equal to zero. There is some non-zero velocity. The electrons are having some non-zero velocity. Okay, therefore, what is drift velocity? Drift velocity is defined as the average velocity with which the free electrons are drifted towards the positive end of the conductor. Towards the positive end of the conductor when under the influence of an external electric field. Under the influence of an external electric field. Are you following? The electrons are drifted from here Y to X only because of what is that? The application of some potential difference, some external electric field. If there is no external electric field, the electrons start moving randomly. Okay, therefore there is no motion in a particular direction. Okay, therefore thermal average velocity will be equal to zero that time. But once you apply the electric field, the electrons are drifted from negative end of the conductor to the positive end of the conductor. Okay, with the velocity, what is called the drift velocity. Drift velocity is nothing but the combination of two velocities, thermal velocity as well as the velocity due to the external electric field. Are you following? So both together, what is that? Consider all the electrons, that is what is called the drift velocity is defined as the average velocity with which the free electrons are drifted towards the positive end of the conductor, okay, under the influence of an external electric field. Are you following? Once again, it is average is very important. Okay, it is not a single electron. It is drift velocity means what is that? There are n number of electrons per unit volume. Okay, so therefore, all the free electrons you have to take into consideration in that conductor. Okay, and all these electrons will be drifted from Y to X. Are you following? Therefore, what is drift velocity? Drift velocity is, once again, it is nothing but the average velocity with which the free electrons, all the free electrons get are drifted towards the positive end of the conductor under the influence of what? The external electric field. So that is what is called the drift velocity. Are you following? Now, therefore, what is the drift velocity of electrons? Therefore, what is the order of drift velocity? You should know. Therefore, what is the drift velocity of electrons? Okay, is of the order. You can say order. Order of drift velocity of electrons is given by 10 power minus 4 meter per second. You just imagine 10 power minus 4 meter per second. Very small, but that gives you current. Because see here the average thermal velocity is 10 power 5 meter per second. Thermal speed. Okay. But thermal velocity that is equal to 0. Are you following? But because of the application of the electric field, the electrons get drifted from negative to positive end of the conductor. Okay. And what is the average drift velocity? Drift velocity here, it is the order is 10 power minus 4 meter per second only. Very, very small. But it cannot be neglected. Why? Because of this drift velocity only, what is that? There is a current in the conductor. Why? Because the electrons are only carrying their current carriers now. From Y to X, the electrons are moving. Then because of that only, the circuit gets completed and hence that will be a current. The current, you know very well, what is the direction of the current? Current is from positive end of the battery to this we have seen. Is it clear? Okay, therefore, now we are going to see the expression. We are going to derive the expression for drift velocity. Okay, now, see, therefore, you know that V is the potential difference applied and E is the the electric field. Let L be the length of the conductor. Okay, Here, this is the electron. Ma, these things I have trained. What is that? This is electrons here. Okay, right. Therefore, now see here. What is let L be the length of the conductor. Okay. Therefore, now you tell me what is V. Therefore, the potential. You see, you know that the electric field. The electric field E can be written as E that is equal to V by L. Electric field that is equal to V by L. Okay. Therefore, what is the direction of electric field? Electric field is from what is it, positive to negative end of the conductor. See, already we have seen this from positive to negative. Therefore, what is, because of the application of this electric field, I told you the electrons, there what is the force on electron? Force on each free electron that is given by F, that is equal to, you know that, minus E, is it? Okay, the negative sign gives that, what is it, shows that the electron is, what is that, experience of force opposite to the direction of the electric field. Why? Because electron will be moving in this direction only, na? Electrons are moving from Y to X, whereas the electric field is in the direction X to Y. Are you following? Okay, therefore, now because of this force, definitely electrons will get some acceleration now. Therefore, what is the acceleration of each electron? What is acceleration? That is nothing but F by M, correct? That is nothing but A. What is A? That is equal to minus EE by M. Minus EE by M. Are you following? Therefore, the electrons are accelerated in the direction opposite to that of the electric field. That is why there is a negative sign. Okay. Now, see, okay, very important here, thing here to note here is, see, the electrons are accelerated in which direction, okay, from Y to X, opposite to the direction of the electric field. That is fine, but whatever, they are accelerated, but the energy gained because of acceleration is lost due to every collision, whatever energy is acquired, everything is lost. Okay, therefore, what is that in freshly, immediately after collision, immediately what is it, is once again it is accelerated. Okay, once again it is acquiring some energy, and whatever energy is acquired, once again it is lost because of the next collision. So like that, every time after every collision, it is getting some energy, and the energy gets lost because of the next collision, successive collisions. Are you following? Therefore, because of this, you cannot, though your expression says that A that is equal to E by M, but A, the acceleration is not proportional to E. Acceleration, but the A is equal to E by M, that's fine. This is true only between two successive collision. Therefore, why? Because A is not proportional to E. Though you can say E is a constant, M is a constant, you can say A is proportional to E now. But you cannot say why? Because it is accelerated. But what is that? The energy due to the acceleration is lost in due to collision. Okay, after that, once again it is getting the energy, then it is lost because of collision, then it is getting the energy, it is accelerated, it is getting the energy, then it is lost. Therefore that is the reason why you can say that what is A is not proportional to E. A is not proportional to E. Very, very important. Are you following? Is it clear? Right. Now, once again, right, these electrons are there, but at the same time, here I told you, no, ions will be there, no, atoms, ions will be there, ions. Once the electron comes out of the atom, then it becomes positively charged ion, no? And these positively charged ions are also under the influence of electric field only. okay, but what can they will also experience, what is that, they will also experience a force due to electric field, definitely, as electrons, because they are also, you know very well, F is equal to, what is that, Q into E. Okay, the ions are also having some charge, therefore definitely, what is that, once one electron is coming, then it will become, what is that, what is the charge of ion, then charge of the ion, one electron comes out, means the charge of the ion will be, what is that, it is will be E, plus E, correct, plus E. But whatever, see, but they cannot move. Why? Because they cannot move. Electrons are moving from Y to X, means positive charge can move from X to Y, yeah? But they cannot move. Why? Because why? They are very heavy. Okay, they are very, very heavy. Okay, that is why, though they are experiencing some force, but they cannot move because they are very heavy. But the electrons, because their mass is very, very less, okay, they can, what is that, they are freely, they can move from Y to X. So that means that the current in the conductor is only because of the motion of the electrons. Once, is it clear? Right. Now, okay, therefore now, now we are going to derive the expression for the drift velocity. For that, see, you know what is the drift velocity. Now, what is the drift velocity? It is the average velocity with which the electrons are drifted towards the positive end of the conductor under the influence of external electric field. Average, very important, right? Now what I'm telling you, see, at any instant of time the electrons are drifted like that, here the electrons are drifted at any instant of time, okay, what is the velocity? Let the first electron, for first electron, let U1, what is the velocity, thermal velocity of the first electron is U1. Okay, so at any instant of time, what is the velocity acquired by, at any instant, okay, the velocity acquired by an electron having thermal velocity U1, thermal velocity for that electron is U1, will be V1, that is equal to, what is the initial velocity of that electron before the, before applying the electric field is U1, that is only thermal velocity it has, plus, okay, after the application of, what is electric field, it is accelerated. Now what is acceleration? A, okay, A tau 1, A tau 1. So listen, see, the velocity acquired by the electron having the thermal velocity U1, okay, that is nothing but V1 for the first electron. First electron whose thermal velocity is U1, na? Okay, so at any instant under the influence of electric field, what is the velocity? Its velocity becomes V1 now. Okay, that is equal to initial velocity, kya hota hai isko? Thermal velocity hai, before applying the electric field, that is U1, plus A tau 1. What is A here? A, you know, that is E by M. What is tau 1 here? Tau 1 is here. What is tau 1? Tau 1 is the time elapsed. The time elapsed since, okay, it suffered, since it has suffered, since it has suffered the last collision, suffered its last collision or previous collision. What do you mean by that? What do you mean by that? See, tau 1 is the time elapsed since it has suffered its last collision. So, it has suffered some collision. After that, what is it? It will be accelerated. It will be accelerated. That what is acceleration? It is E by M. Okay. Therefore, what is tau 1? Tau 1 is nothing but the time elapsed since it has suffered its last collision. Okay, therefore, and now therefore, what is that? If you know, v is equal to u plus at, na? Yeah, what is t here? T is tau 1. What is tau 1? Tau 1 is nothing but the time, because only between two successive collisions it has some acceleration a. Are you following? So now between two successive collision, for example, it has for example here it has suffered one collision here, okay, because after that it is going like this, okay, and this is what is the time here, let the time here, that is equal to tau 1, because since it has it has suffered some previous collision, what is the time here? Tau 1. After some time only it is going to collide with this, what is that, another ion, like that. Therefore this is the time that elapsed since it has suffered the last collision, okay. Therefore v1, that is equal to u1 plus at1, like that. For other electrons, what is the therefore, like that, similarly, what is v2? V2, that is equal to u2 plus a tau 2. What is tau 2? Tau 2 is a time elapsed, okay, for the second electron, for the second electron, okay, since it has suffered the last collision, okay, like that. What is your vn velocity? Everything is at any instant of time, at any instant of time, okay. The first the electron, what is that, the velocity of the first electron whose thermal velocity is u1 is given by v1 is equal to u1 plus at1, okay, where tau is nothing but the time elapsed since it has suffered the last collision. Similarly, what is v2 is equal to u2 plus at2, vn is equal to un plus a tau n. Are you following? Okay, so u1, u2, u3 are its initial velocity before applying the electric field. After applying the field, they acquired some acceleration due to the external electric field, okay, and this acceleration is not constantly. The electrons will have every collision it is losing its energy, therefore once again freshly it will acquire some, what is that, energy, and it will go along with that energy, it will be accelerated, once again it will be lost, like that. That is why that is very very important here. That is very very, it is not the electrons, once they are getting accelerated, immediately they will fly off from one end to another end. They undergo lots and lots of collision, okay. Because of the collision only, you have to, this term tau 1 is very important. Tau 1 comes because of that only. Tau 1 is nothing but what is that time elapsed since the previous collision. Are you following? That is very very important here, okay. Therefore now, so I know now I have what are the velocities of all the electrons, okay, under the influence of electric field is given by v1, v2, v3, etc. up to v1 I have, okay. Now what I want is the drift velocity. Therefore, what is the drift velocity? According to the definition, drift velocity is nothing but average velocity of all the electrons, okay, that are drifted towards, average velocity with which all the electrons are drifted towards the positive end of the battery, a positive end of the conductor under the influence of the external electric field. Therefore, what is the drift velocity? Drift velocity of electrons is given by Vd, drift velocity, okay, that is nothing but it is average of velocity of all the electrons, na? Therefore v1 plus v2 plus v3 plus etc. up to vn divided by n number of electrons. Are you following? Okay, therefore you can say, therefore what is your Vd? Vd, that is equal, what is V1? V1 is U1 plus A tau 1 plus U2, V2, U2 plus A tau 2. Because you know tau 1, tau 2, tau 3, the time elapsed may be different. You know, you cannot say all are having the same time. It is also random only, no? We don't know which electron will undergo collision at what time. So that is why tau 1, tau 2, tau 3, I have taken different timings. definitely all the timings, the time interval between, what is that, at any instant of time, what is that, the first electron would have just suffered a collision, second electron would have suffered a collision long back. Okay, so which means that your timings tau 1, tau 2, tau 3, etc. will be, what is it, definitely it will be different. It will be definitely different. Is it clear? Plus u3 plus a tau 3 plus etc. un plus a tau n. Okay, and divided by, yeah, correct? Okay, therefore VD, that is equal time taking u1, u2, u1 plus u2 plus u3 plus etc. un by n, I am taking it out, plus a tau 1 plus a tau 2 plus etc. a tau n by n. Fine. And now what do you say about this? This is nothing but, what is this? It is average thermal velocity, na? Already we have seen, what is the average thermal velocity? Average thermal velocity, that is equal to kya hai isme? Zero. Okay. Therefore, now you see this will be equal to zero. Okay. Therefore, what is your VD? Therefore, what is your VD? VD is equal to A. Okay. Into tau 1. Tau 2. Okay. A. Plus etc. tau n. Divided by n. Okay. Okay. Therefore, and that is nothing but a tau, where, what is our where, tau, that is equal to tau 1 plus tau 2 plus etc. tau n by n. Okay, what is that, therefore what is tau, this is nothing, what is tau 1, tau n, tau 1 is that time elapsed for the first electron since its last collision, tau 2, time elapsed for the second electron since its last collision. Therefore, tau 1 plus tau 2 plus tau n divided by n will be the average time. This is nothing but average time. Okay. That elapsed. Okay. Elapsed. That has elapsed. Okay. That has elapsed since last or previous collision. Are you following? Okay, that is okay, this is average time that has elapsed since last collision, and that is what is called, okay, average relaxation time. Relaxation time. What is relaxation time? In between, see, it is the time interval between two successive collision. It is average time interval between two successive collision. It is nothing but, what is that? Average time interval between two successive collision. In between two collision, it is relaxed. It is not undergoing any collision, no. Okay, therefore that is why it is what, relaxation time. Between two successive collision, okay, the electron is relaxed. Okay, it is moving nicely towards the positive end of the conductor. Okay, therefore, what is that? That is why it is called relaxation time, or it is the average time interval between two successive collision. And what is the time? The order of this one will be about 10 power minus 4 seconds, 14 seconds. tau. The average value is 10 power minus 14 seconds. Is it clear? Therefore, what is your VD? Let me highlight that. For VD, that is equal to A into tau. That is, what is A? A is equal to minus E by M into tau. Okay, therefore, if I want to represent just in terms of VD, only magnitude, it is EE by M into tau. Are you following? So, this is the expression for, what is that? Drift velocity. This is the expression for drift velocity. And it is a vector form. VD. VD is, drift velocity will be definitely opposite to the direction of the electric field. Therefore, minus EE by M into tau. Just VD means it is EE by M into magnitude. Are you following? Okay. Therefore, this is, now you have idea about what is the drift velocity. And here, drift velocity depends very much on the relaxation time. Okay. Now, I want to introduce one more, I think, what is called mean free path. What is mean free path? Mean free path is nothing but average distance traveled by the electrons between two successive collisions. Average distance traveled by the electrons between two, what is that, successive collisions. Are you following? That is what is called mean free path. Therefore, how do you relate mean free path, okay, tau, relaxation time, and drift velocity? How do you relate? Therefore, mean free path, I want you to relate velocity, distance, and time. That's all. What is that? Mean free path, drift velocity, and relaxation time. Okay, therefore, what is relaxation time? Mean free path, if I am taking it as lambda. Okay, therefore, how do you say mean free path lambda, that is equal to velocity into time? No, drift velocity into time. This is lambda. Are you following? Drift velocity into time. What is time here? Tau. Relaxation. Time means, what is that here? Time here, just tau. Are you following? What is tau? Tau is the average time interval between two successive collisions. What is lambda? It is the average distance traveled between two successive collisions. So, between two successive collisions, the electron is moving with the drift velocity Vd. Therefore, how are they related? Lambda, that is equal to, what is the mean free path, is equal to drift velocity into relaxation time. This may be useful for solving problem. Is it clear? Hope you are following this. Drift velocity. Okay. So, drift velocity. What is the order of drift velocity? What is the order of thermal speed? Thermal speed is 10 power 5. But drift velocity is of the order of 10 power minus 4 meter per second. Is it clear? Now, the drift velocity is very small, but as I told you, it is not negligible. But one thing I just want to tell you here, it is very, very important. See, usually they'll ask this question. Drift velocity is very much less of the order of 10 power minus 4 meter, minus 4 meter per second only. But once you switch on the, immediately after switching on, the current flows. So it is not, how is it possible? Drift velocity is the order of 10 power minus 4 meter per second. But once you switch on, immediately what is the fan runs, the bulb glows, whatever is that. Okay. But the electron is moving with a very small speed of the order of 10 power minus 4 meter per second only. How is it possible? The reason is, what is that? Once you switch on, okay, the electric field will be produced, okay, with the speed of electromagnetic wave, within no second. the speed of what is the electromagnetic wave. So what happens here, see here from for example, see one electron will be moving here like this. Okay, from here there is other segment spinning. Here one electron, it will be moving like this. Here one electron will be there, that will be moving here. Here one electron will be. Therefore, see, there is no need for one electron to move from. It will not wait for one electron to move from y to x. Okay, therefore, what is that? One electron is moving, the other electron will be moving from here, other electron will be moving from here, other electron will be moving from here. Therefore, the circuit gets completed. It won't wait for a single electron to move from one end to another end. Okay, because there are an innumerable number of electrons are there. No, definitely, once you are switching on, all the electrons will be drifted towards the positive end of the circuit, positive end of the conductor. Okay, and though the drift velocity is very, very, very small, but what is that? It won't immediately, what is that? The circuit will get completed because of the collection of so many electrons. All the electrons will be moving from here to here, here to here, here to here. So for what is that? Within no second, the electrons, the circuit gets completed and the current flows. Okay, usually it just won't wait for a single electron to go from y to x. Hope you are following this, right? Right. Next one is, next very important topic, that is mobility. Therefore, what is mobility? What is mobility? See, mobility of the what is the mobility? See, very important is, you know that the current in the conductor is nothing but charge divided by time, correct? Charge divided by time. If the charges, see, charge, the moving charge, the charge has to move at the same time, the time also plays a very, very important role. Okay, that is how mobile the charges are, how freely the charges can move, okay, in a conductor. That is very, very important. Okay, that is how freely the charges can move. That is given by mobility. Mobility of the what is the charge carriers? How freely the charges can move. Okay, therefore, mobility of the charge carrier is nothing but, mobility is usually denoted by mu. What is that? The mobility mu is nothing but the ratio between, what is a drift? It is a drift velocity per unit electric field. The ratio between drift velocity and electric field. Okay, mu, that is equal to Vd by E. Drift velocity per unit electric field. Okay, therefore, even if the electric field is very small, if the drift velocity, if they are drifted very fast, okay, the drift velocity is large, means then you can say the charges are highly mobile. Highly mobile. Okay, therefore, mu, that is equal to Vd by E, and that is nothing but, what is Vd? Vd is nothing but Q E by M into tau. This is Vd. Okay, and divided by E. Therefore, that is nothing but mu, that is equal to Q by M into tau. This is the expression for mobility. Okay, mobility of the charge carriers, the current carriers or charge carriers. Okay, more, if the charge, see, the mobility of charge carriers are only responsible for, what is that, which are responsible for current, because the charges have to be mobile. Okay, once, how freely the charges can move, depending upon that only you will get the current in the circuit. Okay, therefore, what is the relation with the, it is nothing but mu, that is equal to drift velocity per unit electric field. Therefore, if you apply, E and E will get cancelled. Therefore, you will be getting Q by M into tau. Is it clear? Therefore, now, therefore, what is the unit? Unit for unit. Unit of mu, mobility, that is nothing but, you tell me, what is that? Q, Vd by E. Vd is nothing but meter per second, okay, and per Newton per coulomb. Therefore, that is nothing but meter per second coulomb. Meter per second Newton per Newton coulomb. So this is the unit for what is that, mobility. Are you following? Is it clear? Therefore, it can even, you can express in terms of what is that, if you take this one, this is per volt. We see VD by E. E is nothing but V. See, mu, that is equal to, mu is equal to VD by E. That is nothing but, okay, VD by V by L, na? V by L. Therefore, you can, if you apply this, you will be getting in terms of V. What is V? V is nothing but potential difference, na? Therefore, if you apply this, then you will be getting what is a unit here, meter squared per volt. Per volt. Correct? Why? It is nothing but VD L by V. Correct? Per meter per second, meter squared divided by this. So, this is also the unit for what is that, mu, mobility. Is it clear? Right. Now the next topic. Now you have idea about mobility, you have idea about what is it, velocity. Now what is very important question? Okay, it is the relation between current and drift velocity. The relation between current and drift, very very important question. Okay, right. Current and drift velocity. Right. Consider a metal consider a conductor. Okay, metal conductor, a conductor of length L. Okay, and area of cross section A. Area of cross section A. Okay. Now this is the area of cross section is A. And now what I'm doing, this is, I'm applying a potential difference. Okay. V. Okay. Therefore, what is the direction of electric field? Electric field direction will be in this direction. What is the direction of VD? VD, electron will be getting in this. VD will be in the opposite direction. Everything you know, and the current direction will be from here to here. Right. Okay. Now, what is the volume of the conductor? Therefore, now see. Volume of the conductor, that is equal to AL. Volume of the conductor is AL. Okay. Let there be N number of electrons per unit volume. N. Number of electrons. Okay. Per unit volume of the conductor. The wire. Of the conductor or wire. Okay. Whatever it is. It's AB. The XY. Let me have it at XY. Okay. The conductor XY. Okay, therefore L, a number of electrons means which electrons? Free electrons. Very important. Number of free electrons per unit volume of the conductor is XY. Okay, therefore what is the charge? Total number of free electrons in the conductor. That is nothing but N A L. That is equal to N A L. Are you following? Therefore, okay, what is the total charge? Charge of all the free electrons in the conductor, the conductor or wire, okay, conducting wire. Is it clear? Therefore, that is nothing but what is the charge? It is E, na, charge of electron. Therefore, you can say minus E N A N. Is it clear? This is the total charge of all the electrons in the conductor, right? Okay, that charge, let it be total charge, let it be Q. Okay, therefore, now what I want is current, how current and drift velocities are related. Now I want to give the relation between them. Okay, therefore, let T be T be the time taken by the electron to cross, okay, to travel, that is the length L of the conductor. T is the time taken by the electron to travel the length, what is that, L of the conductor. Okay, therefore, what do you say about therefore? What is your T? T that is equal to distance, length divided by VD, correct? Are you following? T that is equal to L by VD, na? Why? T is the time taken by the electron to travel the length L. Okay, therefore electron is moving with a velocity that is nothing but the drift velocity. Therefore T that is equal to L by VD. Okay, therefore it is time taken by the electrons, okay, to cross the conductor. Or to travel the length that is L. Are you following? This is true. Okay. Therefore, what is the current through the conductor? Therefore, current through the conductor, I that is equal to Q by T. Are you following? That is I that is equal to what is Q? Minus E N A L. Okay. Divided by Q. Divided by T. Are you following? Okay. Therefore T, what is T here? That is nothing but I that is equal to minus N A N E, okay, E L divided by what is T? T is L by V D. Therefore, your current I that is equal to minus N E A V D. Are you following? Therefore, this is the expression for the current. I that is equal to minus N E A V D. Okay, therefore negative sign shows that, what is that? The drift velocity is always opposite to the current. Correct? Current, electron will be, current is from X to Y, but the electron will be moving from Y to X. Therefore, that is given by I, that is equal to minus N E A V D.